Hi gamers, after making several upcoming games that you should not miss, today I'm going to tell you the new Metroidvania that will release in this April 2024. Make sure you're in the comfortable position before we go into the list. Alright then, without further ado, let's get started. Ataraxy is a Metroidvania platformer game with SNES style graphics. The game follows the story of Antef, an ancient pharaoh who awakens from eternal sleep to find his kingdom in turmoil. His throne has been stolen and corruption threatens the world. Your mission is to restore the order and peace by exploring interconnected levels, defeating enemies, and uncovering secrets. The poor quality of the trailer indicates that this is a budget game, so do not expect a very polished experience on this one. Homeland is a Metroidvania game with horror elements. The player takes on the role of a man who must rescue his girlfriend who has been kidnapped by strangers for no reason at all. The game's description specifically mentioned that it is a Metroidvania, but I don't know exactly it is Metroidvania or not at all. And if you have any further information about the game's genre, please let us know in the comment section below. The Lost Key provides an engaging and thrilling gaming experience. Players assume the role of a brave knight who is determined to challenge tyranny and stand up for justice. The story unfolds with elements of loyalty, bravery, and resilience as players explore a world filled with betrayal and cruelty. The developers state that combat inspired by Souls-like games adds a layer of depth and intricacy to the gameplay, ensuring a gratifying and engrossing experience for players. Garm Ruins is an engaging exploration-type action game available on Steam that puts players in the paws of Fluffy Girl's Doge. With its key features focusing on simple 2D action gameplay, intricate exploration, treasure hunting, status enhancement, challenging boss battles, and interesting companions, the gameplay of Garm Ruins is designed to be easy to pick up, making it accessible to players of all skill levels. Powernaut Decay is a non-linear platformer that draws inspiration from classic Mega Man and the challenging gameplay of Souls game. Some have suggested that it could be a Metroidvania, but there's no indication that the developer has taken an interest in the genre during development. However, based on the game world design description, it is only one ability gate away from being classified as a Metroidvania. Therefore, it might accidentally fall into the Metroidvania category. Colorblind FX is 2.5D puzzle platformer Metroidvania that follows the Splashians on their quest to restore color to a world that has been desaturated by a villain. The game offers a variety of unique locations to explore, each brimming with mystery and wonder. This changes the world as you go through in a way that 9 Years of Shadow should have done. Feeling interested in this game? What do you think about this one? Moonlight Pulse is a 16-bit traditional Metroidvania with character switching mechanics in its main gameplay feature, allowing players to seamlessly swap between distinct characters to adapt to different challenges, utilize unique abilities, and collaborate effectively to combat the invading parasites. These dynamic gameplay elements add variety to the traditional Metroid formula, providing different playstyles and strategic options to explore the turtle-first world. Shiba New Dawn is a game that combines action, RPG elements, and Metroidvania gameplay. Players will explore the mystical realm of Shiba, encountering ancient ruins and enigmatic puzzles at every turn. The game offers 45 combo skills and elemental finishers, allowing players to wield different elemental swords and craft stylish and powerful combat strategies that will keep them engaged in thrilling battles. I already mentioned this game in another video, and I think this game looks promising. Minishoot Adventures, seamlessly blending elements of classic arcade space shooters with the beloved universe of The Legend of Zelda and Tunic. This indie game takes players on a thrilling journey of alien invasion, where they must rescue friends, upgrade their spaceship, and explore diverse environments. The gameplay mechanics are simple yet well-balanced. Players gain experience points by defeating enemies and can use them to upgrade their fire rate, range, and critical hit chance, resulting in a rewarding progression system. The boss fights stand out as engaging and dynamic, with each stage of the battle introducing new mechanics and testing player skills. Turbo Kid is a retro-futuristic action-adventure game inspired by the 2015 Canadian-New Zealand post-apocalyptic film. The game places in the role of a lone warrior, traveling across a wasteland full of creeps and scoundrels that you must physically battle your way through to survive. Turbo Kid rides a BMX bike, which serves as both transportation and a weapon. Players can perform tricks, evade enemies, and engage in bike combat. You can kill enemies with your blaster gun or machete for melee attacks. This game looks promising. What do you think about this one? Biogun is a visually stunning twin-stick shooter Metroidvania game with a focus on fast-paced combat and exploration. Players will control back and use them the bio blaster to defeat enemies with the option to equip chips for combat and exploration advantage. Exploration is a key element in Biogun, with hidden areas to discover, platforming segments to overcome, and upgrades to collect. Boss battles present diverse and challenging encounters, each requiring a unique approach based on the enemy attack patterns. The Devil Within Sadgat is an upcoming action platformer that follows the journey of Kimrip, a royal guard who is looking to uncover the mysteries of a new desolate world. The game features advanced offensive, defensive, and mobility abilities, precise controls, and an immersive story. The game world design follows the traditional Metroidvania approach, where the entire world is open for exploration. This game combines combat draw from classic fighting games with Kimrip dodging, parrying, and using time strikes to rack up maximum damage. Akatori Chapter 1 is a Metroidvania game that focuses on melee combat with a stick. The game was originally called Dead Stick and has been in development for almost 10 years. It appears that the project was stuck in development hell during this period, but it emerged last year with a completely remade 2.5 pixel art style. The new art style has received mixed reviews from fans, however, the prequel will be only be available on Steam for obvious reasons. Biomorph is an upcoming Souls-like Metroidvania game about harnessing the forms and abilities of defeated monsters. The game has a smooth and dynamic feel, with combat mechanics inspired by enemy attack patterns seen in other games, leading to a tough but satisfying experience that ends with an epic boss battle. Of course, the standout feature is its monster mask mechanics, which allows players to assume the forms of defeated creatures. From a hellish unicorn to a formidable meat golem, each transformation offers unique abilities that unlock new paths and strategies. Tales of Kenzera Zao. This is the most highly anticipated release of the month, a 25D Metroidvania with a lot of original mechanics being published by Electronic Arts. In this emotionally charged adventure, players take on the role of Zao, a young shaman who bargains with the gods of the dead to bring his father back from darkness. The game draws inspiration from the rich myths of Bantu cultures and features cosmic powers, rhythmic combat, and a universe awash with color and depth.
Powerful mask. It is the mask of the moon. Baba taught me the ways. Graceful is the flow, a harmony soaked in virtuous intent. The mask of the sun.
And that's it for today. What do you think about this new Metroidvania in this April? I'm really excited about Biomorph and Kenzera Zao. What's yours? If you enjoy this video, please like this video and make sure subscribe this channel if you don't want to miss another great list. As always, thank you for watching and see you in the next video.